But I liken what we need to do to a patient who has just learned that they have cancer. I think America has a spending cancer. And you go to your doctor, and the doctor says, you know what? The bad news is you have cancer. But the good news is there's a treatment. Now, the person that wants to be well might say, well, I want the chemotherapy treatments that you offer, and I want them all right now. The doctor says, that's not prudent, for we certainly would kill the cancer, but unfortunately, we would kill the patient. But what we're going to do is we're going to put in place a manageable treatment. And we're going to have 40 treatments. And over the period of time, we're going to shrink the cancer while allowing the patient to be strong each and every day and to have a good, healthy life. And I think we've got to do similar things at the nation's highest level to ensure a treatment plan to our sickness of overspending. This past year, I was proud to be a key sponsor in Cut, Cap, and Balance, a wonderful opportunity for Washington's overspending to be reined in, to say, you know what, we're gonna cut this year's deficit in half, from $1.8 trillion deficit down to $900 billion. We're gonna do that right off the bat. Then we're going to implement caps on spending. Currently, our spending based to what our GDP is around 25%. It's not sustainable. But over the last 70 years, we've averaged between 18 to 20% of spending to GDP. And so what we claim in Cut, Cap, and Balance, that we would bring that spending back down to that proper level, 18 to 20%, not immediately, but over a 10-year period, which I believe is similar to the treatment plan that a cancer patient understands.